Hello friends, welcome to my channel. In this lecture, we are going to focus on a new database problem on movie database. Let us see the schema. So this schema has five entities. As we can see that there are actors, director, movies, movie cast and rating. So based on this, following are the queries being given. Let us try to address one by one question. Find the movie names where one or more actors acted in two or more movies. List all the actors who acted in a movie before 2000 and also in a movie after 2017. So they asked us to use join operation. Find the title of movies and number of stars for each movie that has at least one rating and find the highest number of stars that movie received. And also they asked us to sort the result by the title of the movie. We have to update the rating of all the movies directed by Subhash Ghai to 3, and also there is a new concept being asked here to use a cursor to display all the details of all the movies along with this ID and title from the database. Let us see one by one with the help of a ER diagram. So in this entity relationship diagram, we can see there are three entities: actor, director and movies. So actor is having a relationship with the movies in terms of movie cast, and we have m number of actors acted in casted in n number of movies. Similarly, n number of movies can be directed by an author here, so it is n is to 1 here. And we have phone and the review stars as a multivalued attribute. Movie ID in the movies becomes a primary key or a key attribute over here. Director ID is a key attribute and actor ID is also acting as a key attribute. So this is an entity relationship diagram, and also we can also see that there are total participation and partial participation here. So movies to movie cast and director directed by becomes a total participation because movies has to be directed by one or the other director and it has to be casted by one or the other actor. So it becomes a total participation here. So with the help of ER diagram, let us see how to create the tables here. Create table actor, we have actor ID, actor name and gender, wherein actor ID is acting as a primary key. We have director, where director ID is a primary key here, and director name and phone number are the candidate keys. We have movies, wherein movie ID, title, year and language along with the director ID has been given. Here director ID is acting as a foreign key and movie ID as a primary key. We have movie cast, actor ID, movie ID, role been given, and primary keys are actor ID and a movie ID, and also these two becomes a foreign key attribute also. We have rating, where we have movie ID, review stars, primary key becomes both movie ID and review star, because for each movie there can be multiple reviews, and movie ID is also a foreign key attribute in this case. Okay, so based on the table structure, we had started inserting some values here for the actor, director, movies, movie cast and rating. Okay, now let us go to the demonstration and let us see how each and every SQL queries has been addressed. I had already created the table here, and also table structure is also been given. Let me show you one by one. We have created a database of movies. In that we have tables, we have actor, director, movie cast, movies and rating, and based on that we had inserted the values for actor, movies, we have movie cast, we have director and rating. Now let us see how to write the queries for each and every SQL questions been asked, right? Let's start writing it. So before that we'll see what is the question been asked here. Find the movie names where one or more actors acted in two or more movies. Let us see how to write the query for this. First we need to select the distinct so that only unique values movie titles will be displayed here. m.movie_title, right? From, we know that it is taken from movies table m along with the we required movie cast to ensure that actors have acted in that movie. Movie cast mv. Right, and where condition comes for the equality, where m.movie_id equal to mv.mov_id, and actor id should act in that movie, right? So we are checking for within, so that it checks for the multi set of tuples. In select the actor ID from movie cast, from the movie cast, right? Group by actor ID, and finally checking whether two or more actors, one or more actor been acted in two or more movies, right? One or it should be count should be greater than one. So having count of movie ID should be greater than one, right? So I think it should be the movie cast. Sorry, I written the name of the relation wrongly. It should be movie cast. Okay, rest all things are fine here. So these are the title of the movies where one or more actors acted in two or more movies. Okay, let us go to the second query. List all the actors who acted in the movie before 2000 and also in the movie after 2017. So in this case, we need to be very careful because we need to select only those actors' name who had acted before 2000 but after, and also after 2017. They should not act anywhere in between 2000 to 2017. So in this case, we can think that using between operator, we can easily write the query, but it will not give you the right answer in all the cases. For example, if you inserted a value like Shah Rukh Khan has acted or any actor acted in a movie before 2000 but not even one movie he has acted after 2017 or after 2000, so that tuple also will get displayed. Now in this case, what we need to do, either you have to use intersect operator or you have to use exist operator. These are the only two options you get, right? So now let us see how to write the query for this. We need to select the actor name, that is A underscore act underscore name, from we required to use a join, so I'll use join here. From actor A, I'll join it with the movie cast. From actor A with the movie cast C, so on equality condition, A dot act underscore ID equal to C dot act underscore ID, right? So this entire result set I'm going to join it again with the movies M on C dot movie underscore ID is equal to M dot MOV underscore ID, and right? So after this I'll use where condition, where the movie here MOV underscore here should be less than 2000. Now for this query, what I get Shah Rukh Khan as a reason. That means that there is an actor who has acted before 2000, it is only Shah Rukh Khan. Now let me execute the same query with respect to the year about 2017. Okay, let me see greater than 2017, who are those actors acted. We have around 6 actors who had acted, actually not 6, it is 5, because Yash has been repeated twice, right? So here out of 5 actors, we can see that only Shah Rukh Khan has acted above after 2017. That means I want only Shah Rukh Khan as the output here, because Shah Rukh Khan is the only actor who has acted before 2000 and also after 2017, right? So I want only these two results. So what do I need to do for these two queries? I need to use a intersect operator or exist operator. So I write the query in this way: less than 2000, right? Less than 2000, and I just use exist operator, exist. Okay, after this I'll make use of, again select same query I'm going to write, but after 2017, right? So I get the output Shah Rukh Khan. So he is the right answer for this particular query. Okay, let us go to the third query. Find the title of the movies and number of stars for each movie that has at least one rating. So you need to give me the details of those movies which has got at least one rating, and also I required the highest number of rating for those movies, and later I need to sort it as per the title of the movie. let us write the query, select m dot movie underscore id, right? After that I want highest, right? So it is max of r dot rev underscore stars as rating, okay? Or you can write highest rate from which table we required movies, right? Movies m comma rating r, right? And we use where condition for equality. M dot mov underscore id is equal to r dot mov underscore id, right? And we'll group by it, group by m dot mov underscore id, and later we'll check having the count at least minimum one rating, right? R dot rev underscore stars. We cannot use min of r dot rev underscore, because for one movie you'll get multiple ratings. You'll get multiple ratings. In that, I need to count at least one rating some people had given. So this I can do only using count. Okay, count of r dot rev underscore, at least one rating has been given by any one of the user. And later I need to sort it. So order by is a command. Order by m dot mov underscore id. That's all. So these are the movies. You can see all are in order as per movie IDs, like 1 to 9. And these are the ratings for each movies, right? So next query is to update the rating of all the movies directed by Subhash Ghai to 3. Okay, I want only those rating to be updated to 3 which are directed by Subhash Ghai. So this is a very easiest query. For that I need to use update command, right? Update rating table, right? And I need to set the review stars to 3, right? Where that movie ID should be MOV underscore ID. Movie ID in, I need to select that movie ID, right? So select MOV underscore ID from movies table. From movies where director underscore ID in, select director underscore ID. Select dir underscore id from director, right? From director, where director underscore name equal to Subhash Ghai, right? So this is a small mistake I might have done. Let me verify it once. So I need to update the rating of Rev Stars to 3 where MOV underscore ID in select. Okay. Yeah. I think we updated the row match here. So set Rev Stars equal to 5. I done instead of 3. It's okay if you can make it to 3, also not a problem here. Maybe small syntax error might have been there. I had corrected it there and there. Right, so this is how we do for a update query. Now let us see how to write a cursor here. So cursor can be declared in database. Actually, how do you define a cursor? Actually, cursor is a pointer that points to a row in the result set to the query associated with it. That means when you execute a statement like select star from student, and we know that in the database there will be multiple records of students, right? So whenever we are going to make use of this result set, so we cannot store it in a single variable. Like for example, from the front end application you are going to execute the statement, and database will directly provide you the entire result set, and this entire result set cannot be stored in a single variable. So what we do means we make use of this cursor. So what cursor will help us to achieve here is, cursor will point to the single row at a time. So one by one row it will fetch you, so that you can store each and every attribute in a variable. And finally it will go for a looping like that. After first row it will go for the second row until it reaches the last loop. So we make use of this looping conditions and all here. Okay, let us see how to write the query for this for a cursor. What do you need to do here? It has to display all the details of the movie ID and title in the database. I written already the cursor program here for you. Let me show you. So this is how you write in MySQL database. It differs when you try to write this in MS SQL or in Oracle database. So we need to use the delimiter $ at the beginning. After that, you need to create a procedure here. Inside the procedure, I written one cursor. Just to show you how to embed the cursor inside the procedure also. So we have create procedure. The name of the procedure movies details one. It has a parameter here. You can see here in and out. In is actually an input parameter. Out is output parameter. If you write in and out together for any particular variable, it becomes that particular attribute can be considered input as well as output variable also. So we have ID varchar of 1000 I had given and in out title varchar of 4000. So what I did means I want to display the ID and title. Only these two variables I taken as of now. In future, if you want to fetch more and more number of details, you can do so. So we had written the enter query with using the begin and end tag. And within that, I need to declare the variables now. Okay. This is one flag variable is underscore done just to verify whether the looping is complete or not. Okay. I'll let you know later. The default value what is set is 0. Now I want to declare a two variable movie underscore ID integer of 10 and movie underscore title varchar of 30. Right? In after declaring the variables, we need to declare the cursor. Cursor is declared as declare cursor name and cursor for the query iterate. Select movie ID, movie titles for movies. So when you execute this the query, what will happen means you will get a bulk of results, right? We call it as a result set. Right, this result set entirely cannot be stored in movie ID or title at a time, because one variable can store at the max one value, right? We all know that. So that is the purpose we are using this cursor. Now what this cursor is going to do, we'll see. Now I need to check whether I need to continue until the entire particular result set ends, right? So I need to write declare continue. You continue the handler until you are not found, means until this particular flag is set to 1. So I need to open the movie cursor 1 here because you have declared it. Once you declare a cursor, you need to open it. Now you are going for a loop. This is just a label of the loop. Okay, you are going for a loop. Fetch movie cursor 1. That means when you execute this query, this is under inside the movie cursor 1, right? So you are going to fetch it into movie ID and movie title. So what you are going to fetch from movie cursor 1? You are fetching the ID and title of the movie. That means the first value is ID, first row second value is title. Only one value you are going to get, that you are going to put it into movie ID and title. And you are checking if is done equal to 1. It is not equal to 1 because you have 5, assume you have 5 tuples. So 5 times it is going to go. So this if condition will fail, right? Again you are going to fetch it. So you will be fetching until all the records have been, right, stored in the variable. After that you are going to set the ID. You are going to set the ID as concat movie ID ID. That means you are going to display right at the end, right? So as the output you want to display means you have to write like the movie underscore ID. You can put semicolon or any other operator ID. Concat movie title title, like that. If you want after movie title like author ID, actor ID, actor name and director ID, you can also write that. And once you're done, you have to end the loop and close the cursor and end the delimiter, right? Let us see how to execute this particular cursor in database. Hope you understand this. Okay, let me also explain you when I'm going to demonstrate you this. Now I'm going to copy this entire thing. First, let me start it from here. I need to write delimiter dollar. Okay, after that let me execute from the beginning. Use movie is the database name. What we have here is delimiter $, right? After this I need to execute up to here. So create a procedure. is the movie cursor. We execute it one by one. So you can see here the cursor has been created, right? Now after this we have to close it once again and open it again. I will let you know how to execute this, right? Use movie. Now here we need to make use of this particular thing. So we need to set the ID and title to null value. After that you can call and you can select the ID. This is how we do. So this is the output of the cursor. You can see here, set the @ID is equal to null and set the rate @title equal to null. After that call, this is how you call a procedure, call procedure, and this is the parameter what I passed, and automatically it has already fetched. I had explained you. And that is what it is going to give it to you. 9 8. See, after every particular semicolon we had given, this is the format what we had given: 9 8 7 6 5 4 3 2 1. And these are all the titles. It is coming in order, right? So this is the cursor here. Hope you understand this, guys. Thank you for watching. Happy learning. Please do subscribe my channel for more facts on DBMS. Thank you very much.